In this video, we will create a sample ASP.NET Web API application and consume them using different types of clients. For that, first click on File, New Project. Select ASP.NET MVC for Web Application. Put a nice name, My First Web API, and say OK. And here is the ASP.NET MVC for project dialog box. Select Web API and say OK. So here it is what we have. Web API project template includes a sample Web API called values with it. If you are an ASP.NET MVC developer, then you may find lots of features in Web API are similar to MVC. They are not exactly same, but as an ASP.NET developer, you can definitely reuse your knowledge here. But if you are not a ASP.NET MVC developer, then these things are going to be new for you, but it's not going to be difficult for you. Let's look at some common features. In MVC, we have something called as MVC controller, whereas in Web API, we have something called as API controller. The difference between these two controllers are, in API controller, action methods are actually HTTP methods like get, post, put and delete. Even we can overload these methods if required. We'll look into these methods in detail shortly, but before that, let's discuss about one more feature, that is routes. Let's take a look at MVC default routes and try to understand how MVC requests work. For that, expand this app_start folder. We have routeconfig.cs file here. Open it. Here it is MVC default routes. When request comes to MVC, it takes the URL and parses the first three segments of the URL. And the first segment is controller. It finds the class with this name. Then we have action. And it literally finds the method inside this controller with this name. And we also have default or optional ID parameter here. Just like this, in Web API, we have default Web API routes. Just to keep it separate from MVC routes, Web API routes are prefixed with the word API. We can change this name to anything like Invoice API, Customer API, or maybe Facebook API as per our requirement. Then we have controller and we have optional ID parameter. The beauty here is we don't have actions here. The reason behind that is actions are actually HTTP methods. And depending on the type of client request, for example, if it's a get request, then get method get called. If it's a post request, then post method get called, and so on. Let me close these both the files and move to our controller. What I will do is I will put a breakpoint here and execute the application. Okay, now as per the route config, I have to put API has prefix here and my controller name is values controller, so values and press enter. Oh great, breakpoint is here. If I press F5, I get the XML representation of my string array. It's that simple. So let's look at the same request using Fiddler. For those who don't know what is Fiddler is, Fiddler is a web debugging tool which logs all HTTP traffic between our computer and the internet. It also let us make requests and also let us modify the HTTP address as per our convenience. You can pause the video and copy the URL and download the Fiddler to your computer. Okay, let me open Fiddler. What I will do is click on this Composer tab and we'll make a new GET request to our Web API and click on the execute. Okay, we get success message. Now let's look at the output we got. When we click on the raw, what we can see here is we are getting JSON representation of our string data. If you remember, when we made the request using Chrome, we got XML representation, whereas in case of Fiddler, we are getting it as JSON. The reason behind that is we have something called as except. Except is a field in HTTP header. It specifies what kind of response a client can accept. Default, what we say, default accept value for Chrome is XML, whereas for Fiddler it is JSON. But in Fiddler we can change that like this: accept colon application slash XML and say execute. Okay, we got a success. Now if I click on raw, what I can see is I am getting a XML representation of my string variable. If I click on compose and change this XML back to JSON and click on execute, what I can see is I am again getting the JSON. This concept is called as content negotiation. Depends on the client request, server is returning the format. When client say I want XML, it gives XML. When client say JSON, we say it gives JSON. Even if we want, we can return our own custom format like visiting card or anything, or image, or it may be anything. Depends on our requirement, we can change the accept value and client, and if it is supported in the server, it will return the same format. Now let's try to create something more interesting. First of all, in this video we will only talk about get methods. We will try to cover post, put and delete methods in further coming videos. So let me remove this. Okay. And let's create a small class called customer inside our model. And let's create two properties inside this. First one is int property called customer ID. Let's make it I capital. Okay, and let's create our second property, a string property called customer name. It's that simple. Next, we will move back to our controller, that is value controller, and just instead of returning this string, what we will do is we will say we will return customer and say import. Okay, and here I will say customer. Okay, fine. Now I will say if I equal to 1 1, then return new customer, customer ID equal to 1, comma customer name Sukesh Marla, else if I equal to 2, then return, oh what happened, oh sorry, ID. Okay, if I equal to 2, then return new customer, customer ID as 2, comma customer name equal to new customer, fine. Okay, or else I will return null. Okay, it's simple. And again, what we will do is here we will write something like this: new list of customer. Here I will say this, enter, and this. Okay, we are ready with our controller. We just created two get methods inside it. One returning list and second returning a single customer. Now let's consume this web API. We will consume this web API first using Google Chrome, second using Fiddler, and third we will write jQuery and try to consume the same. So let's start with Google Chrome. What we will do is we'll just run this application. Okay, it's there. Say slash API slash values. Okay, we got it. We got the XML representation of our list of customer. This is because entering a URL and pressing enter, that means we are actually making get request to our web API. Let me put breakpoint here and run it again. Okay, see, breakpoint is getting hit here. When I say continue, I'm getting the XML. Okay, now let me try with another get method. overloaded get method. Okay, when I put 1, I am getting Sukesh Marla in return. Let me put breakpoint there and let me try with second parameter, say 2. I will press enter. Okay, it's there. Say F10. Okay, ID is not matching. Now ID is matching. We are getting new customer in return. Okay, that's it. We got the new customer here. If I pass something else other than 1 and 2, then I'm getting, okay, ID is not matching. Again, ID is not matching. I'm getting null. Okay, we are getting nothing. That's it. It's that simple. We just consumed our web API using Google Chrome. Now we will try the same using Fiddler. For that, let me launch Fiddler once again. Fiddler is here. Let's click on Composer and let's make a get request to our web API. Here is the web API, and we got JSON representation of our list of customer now. If we change the accept as we did earlier to application/XML and say execute, and if we check the result, here it is, we got the XML representation. Similarly, we can make request to our another customer, another get method, and output is here in XML format. You can see we are Sukesh Marla is here. If we change the accept type to JSON back, then we will get the result in JSON format. So it's that simple. We can use Fiddler for the testing purpose because we can test it for various formats and all. Now the final demonstration where we will try to consume our web APIs using jQuery. For that, we have a small web application called web API test with us, with a simple button and a jQuery support. Here we have jQuery or JavaScript click handler for the button, and our task is to write a code which will consume the web API and display the result. So let's start coding. In jQuery, we have something called as $.ajax, which we can use to consume web API. It has parameters like URL which will accept, which will take the web API URL. Then we have type, which will tell which method we are going to invoke, like get, post or something else. Next, it has data type, what kind of format we are expecting in return. We are expecting JSON for now. Next, we have a callback method called success, which get called when the result is returned from web API. It has a parameter called data. Now let's start with, okay, what we will do is we will put an alert and say data.customer name. Now let's put a breakpoint in our web API here and let's run this application. Now you notice as soon as we click on this button, we are getting breakpoint here. If you notice, the value of ID is now 1, so definitely we are going to get this customer in return. When I say F5, I'm getting in alert Sukesh Marla, which is because of this code block. Similarly, if we try to consume a previous get method which is going to return a list of customer, then definitely we are supposed to make a loop on customers. We can do it like this: data comma, it has a function called as function e comma customer. Then what we have to do is we have to say alert when we have customer dot customer name, then Yeah, nothing. That's it. Now, if I press Control F5 here and try to click this button, I'm getting Sukesh Marla and new customer as well. So here we finish our simple demonstration of how to create and consume ASP.NET Web APIs. Hope you enjoyed. If you have any query, you can write to us and we will try to reply with the best possible way we can. Thank you.